We're live.
All right, we're live. Hello, welcome to Mav Smash. This is the MNSU Smash Club, and we are doing a weekly tournament matches right now.
First match is
Jay Ian versus Lithium Sheep. Jay Ian is Bowser and Lithium Sheep. Appears to be Zero Suit Samus right now. Solid start from Samus. A lot of shields encountering. Bowser having a little trouble.
Alright,
yep. Bowser with the grab.
Basically, what Zero Suit's gonna wanna do here is just basically wall her out, or wall Bowser out.
Yeah.
Keep him as far away. Possible.
Yep, because Zero Suit's a very fast character, so she can keep him at range if she wants to.
That tether grab will get him.
Yeah. But if Bowser... Zero Suit is very light, so if Bowser does hit her, it's going to do a lot of damage. But that's going to be hard, and that's what Jayin's going to have to do here.
That was a very risky way to get back on the stage.
Yeah. Oop, using the up the elf. Got edge grab. And no problem.
You missed a good punish opportunity right there with Bowser.
Yep. What? We have a shout out request from Mohammed Mombreezy, who is the president of Smash Club.
Shout out
to Momo.
Over here. And there goes Bowser off the top.
Alright. That's the first kill. Samus is at 88, so in theory this is anyone's game if Bowser gets a solid hit in. Oh. Because if Bowser can nail with that with the grab. Oh, there we go.
A nice forward smash right there.
Yep. Now we're nice and even. Bowser at 8%. Sam's still at nothing. Invincibility's worn off, and let the games begin. They're literally neck and neck. This is a very close game.
That was a great spot dodge right there.
Sam's blocking, dodging, keeping Bowser at range here. Using her speed to her advantage. Oh, it's a good hit from Bowser. Oh, can Samus get back up? Oh, can Bowser get back up? Yes, and yes. Right. Still very even. Bowser's ahead just a little bit. But a solid hit right now from either one of them could mean the game in either direction.
Really, Zero Suit really missed a couple of punishes there, but...
Yeah.
Really keep Bowser in the air a little bit, but I can see where they're a little fearful of that downbeat.
Yeah. No, absolutely. Alright, Samus is just about up to 97%. Ooh, there's another solid hit from Bowser. One more and she might be done here. Ooh, good dodge. Good grab, alright. Now Samus can hit him with the up B. This match will be over. Ooh, just a couple of misses here.
There we go. Oh,
oh man. A stun and then nothing. There's a grab. Oh, and there's the up B. Game over. Samus wins, Lithium Sheep takes first round. This will be a...
First game.
Alright, and this will be a two-match...
Or best of three.
It's a best of three. Two stock, no items, stages must be agreed upon beforehand. Tournament is full single elimination. We have 17, 18 competitors? 17,
yes,
I believe.
17
competitors.
It looks like Jane's going to stick with Bowser.
Alright. After the first round, the loser may counter-choose a character, if they so desire. Looks like he has not. So we have another Bowser versus Zero Suit Samus on Battlefield this time, so we got a few platforms in there. This might actually work more to Bowser's advantage. Although Samus is still very quick, so we'll see how she maneuvers around the stage.
Samus can really trap him up on the top of the platforms during this game. Paralyzed.
Yep. Seems to be doing that right now. There we are. Bowser's just getting pushed around a whole bunch right now. Yeah. If Bowser can stay in the middle there, he should be able to defend his position, because he's very strong melee. Although, Samus can always come in from the side for the... Ooh, Bowser almost fell off the edge of it. With a dash or... Oh, Bowser SDs. That is unfortunate. So, Zero Suit Samus may be taking this one as well. So 62%. Already getting some solid hits in on Bowser. Bowser trying to stay low. good hit there on Samus. Bowser may be able to get a kill here, but I don't see him winning this round, match, this game. Oh. Solid hit. Bowser can get another hit in, and he may take at least one life off Zero Suit Samus before the round's over. Sam's still trying to keep Bowser at range. Bowser's getting up high percent now too. Oh, there we go. One life off, but Bowser's still way more damage than Samus right now.
Bowser's definitely big enough to survive.
Yeah. Now he can certainly take a lot of punishment, but if Samus gets a good solid hit in, right? Just like that. Ooh. Oh, Bowser's still alive.
I'd be surprised there's not a Bowser side to this one. Honestly.
Yeah.
But, there's no Bowser's.
That's game over. Lithium Sheep wins this round. Alright, looks like next match will be Sorcerer versus Crab.
Sorcerer versus Crab.
So, just give us a moment while we gather our participants.
Yeah, we've been around since last spring. Trying to grow as much as possible, but
yeah, we certainly have grown a lot just this year. First Smash Club had maybe 8 people. We seem to have a good 20 people or so just hanging around here now. Not to mention 17 solid combatants here. So this is going to be a very interesting tournament. Oh. All right, our combatants have gathered. They are searching for names, it seems, right now. Yes, sir. Oh, he's resetting his controls. Oh, you know, he's serious then. He's just resetting some controls. All right. And we should.
Sorcerer versus Crab.
Yep. Okay. We have a name mix up, but we're all good now. So this match will be Sorcerer versus Crab. Sorcerer with King Deity, and Crab is Dark Fox. Well, this should be an interesting match. Fox is a very light, long range type character. Deity, very heavy, close range. But we'll see if he can hit him with a solid Gordo once in a while. We're in Town City here.
Fox is basically going to just rush down this matchup.
Yep.
This is the best opportunity. But Deity has much more range than a hammer with all of his projectiles.
Yep.
Has reflective.
Yeah, absolutely. But Fox can always get around a larger character with his side B there. Although Deity seems to be doing very well for himself on this rather small map. Not a lot of platforms at all, just the one or two that occasionally come around. Indeed, you're doing a very solid job right now. Using that hammer to good use.
Crab's a newcomer here over at Smash Match. This is his first matchup here at the club. And we've seen Sorcerer here for a couple weeks this year.
This is true. Sorcerer is a very fresh face, but we haven't seen him play yet. He's doing very well, so.
Dude, he's young as hell. That's the still in high school.
That is true. Oh my gosh, is he really? I didn't even know we took high school people here. But you know what? As long as they can smash it, I don't see the problem.
We're fine with that.
We're absolutely fine with that. Ooh, nice Gordo hit on the edge.
I should do it right there.
Yep. Deity takes first life. Oh, Deity's still at 107, so if Fox can get a solid hit on Deity, might be able to tie it up. Yep.
That's a pretty low ceiling.
It does have a pretty low ceiling. Although Deity is already getting that damage up on Fox, already up to 50%. With the quick taunts. Well, that's disrespectful. I love it. Yep. Fox is dodging very well. Deity off the edge. See if Fox can get at least one kill in this game. Alright. So that is a kill from Fox. And it was one life to one life. It's, Fox is at 73%. So, oh. Now he's already 101. And that should be game. Good job. Sorcerer takes first round as DDD. So now Crab gets a chance to change his character if he so desires.
And Sorcerer will claim.
Alright, let's see. Will he change characters?
Really trying to figure out if he wants to switch.
Right. And Crab's not going to switch. It's Fox versus DDD, it seems. Battlefield? Battlefield it is. Fox versus DDD and Battlefield.
This really can work to Fox's advantage, getting kills off the top with his up smash.
Yep. Yeah, this map has a rather low ceiling, but man, in this match and the last match, we've seen the shift from the very low platform stage to Battlefield. Battlefield is an incredibly neutral stage.
Oh,
Fox with the SD, that is tragic. Oh, DDD with the SD. DDD with the SD in kind. Match is completely even. 0-0, one life each.
And that worked just as planned.
Right, Fox getting up close and personal. Oh, yeah, don't. There you go. Fox staying a little bit back. Ooh, using that. Using the shield to good use. Fox is getting the hits on King DDD there. Crab may be able to take this one. You get a nice good hit off of DDD right here, then he'll take the round.
He's definitely increased his play here.
Yeah, absolutely. He seems to adapt it a little bit more to Sorcerer's play style.
He read the roll there.
Yep. We're good.
Nice punish there.
Fox keeping low. Right. One more good hit. Ooh. That should be it. Ooh. DDD's still in this. Fox is still at 81%.
Fox definitely has to be careful right here.
Yeah.
He can get hit.
Yeah, because if DDD hits him with that hammer, then he is absolutely out. This is anyone's game within one hit right here. And there it is.
Fox bringing it back.
Crab takes game two. All right. We're looking at round three. Round three hype. So now I believe Sorcerer has a chance to change characters. See if he will do that or not. He has done well as King DDD in the last couple of rounds. He, without the SDs at the beginning, that match might have gone quite a bit differently. Discussing a little bit right now. Alright, he's going with DDD again. Fox versus DDD, round 3. Let's say Smashville again. Alright. This is Crab versus Sorcerer, round 3. Fox opening with some lasers. Fox laying on the heavy punishment. DDD is getting thrashed around, hasn't got a single hit on Fox. King DDD is already at 97%. Crab being absolutely relentless this game. Oh my.
Go for the zero.
Yeah. And that's a kill already. I don't even think we're 30 seconds in. Fox is at 42%, already has a kill on DDD.
I'm just not noticing that we don't have a timer on here.
We do not.
We completely goofed on that.
We probably should have set a timer.
Well, see, no one's camping, so we're good.
Yeah, no, nobody's. I don't think anybody's going to be camping. We all want to. All want to move this along. Fox with a good shield there. Fox still not quite high enough damage for DDD to knock him out just yet. But he is getting there. If DDD works a little bit,
yeah.
Oh, there we go. Good hit on Fox. DDD just missing with a hammer there. Alright. Fox is now just high enough damage. DDD can get a good hit on him. We'll take at least one life off Fox. Ooh, that might be it. Nope. Not quite.
My roommate, John.
Fox dodging, jumping quite well. I don't think he's gotten a single Gordo hit. Oh, there it is. There's a hammer side swipe.
That takes bringing it back down to one stocks, but he's quite high percent against his Fox.
Yeah. So DAD is quite efficient in dealing a lot of damage.
Very quickly, too.
Yeah. So if DAD can get the damage up on Fox, he may still take the round. But Fox might just be too fast. There you go. Keeping it rather even. Fox at 44%, DAD at 94%, DAD at 103%.
He's really trying to show DAD that 20XX is still alive. This is a definite goal here.
Yep. Fox just needs a few more hits and then one good smash on DAD. DAD still needs to get... He needs to get Fox up there, but, you know, he is certainly getting up there. Ooh, there's a hammer smash.
Oh.
And that is it. Turnabout. Sorcerer wins. Sorcerer takes this round. Oh, what an upset.
Got the bracket. Select the bracket. He's next.
All right, so next match is Too Much Dog versus Mr. Two Sock.
Jeff, you're playing and then Too Much Dog. We got Jeff here.
So
one of the originals.
Yeah, Jeff has been with the club, I think basically since its founding. He's had a rivalry with the president, and they've been in the finals for the last couple of rounds, tournaments we've had.
The first one to talk the most smack. I know he does.
Oh, absolutely.
I have to back it up, though. I know he has a decent little match.
No, he can dish it out, but he certainly can take it, too.
Add a timer on there.
Yeah, put a timer on there. And I think this is going to be Jeff versus Too Much Dog. And this is Ross the Boss, winner of one of our first tournaments here. So this is certainly going to be an interesting match here. This is something you're not going to want to miss.
So is he going to go little Matt? We'll see. And actually, I know him too much dog here, too. Yeah. And he's going to go for, look, give me that sneaky smile right there.
Do you think he's going to go little Mac of this?
Oh,
he's Yoshi.
I love his Yoshi. That's the thing.
Ross's Yoshi spikes are legendary.
We're going Ness versus Yoshi.
Ness versus Yoshi.
This is a great match.
Yeah, rather small characters, rather fast characters. Characters with good long-range attacks. And I've seen Ross play Yoshi plenty of times. I haven't seen Jeff play Ness too much, but...
Oh, no, he loves his
This is absolutely going to be an insane match. I cannot wait for this. What way are they going to go here? Looks like they're going to do an Omega stage here.
Any stage now.
Yeah. Palutena's Temple. It's just the scenery. And you know what? Palutena's Temple is pretty good on scenery, I gotta say. Alright. Omega Palutena's Temple. This is Jeff versus Ross the Boss. Too Much Dog versus Mr. Two Stock. Ness versus Yoshi.
That's how you know he's confident. He's going straight for Mr. Two Stock.
Alright. Oh, what a high-flying match we've got already. They're keeping it neck and neck, 28-25. Ness just getting in those PK things, keeping Yoshi at a slight distance if he possibly can. Yoshi doing his best to get up close and personal. There it is. Yoshi's a rather strong melee character, but with those egg throws, and Ross can absolutely snipe with egg throws. He can do some serious damage there.
Ooh.
Almost got that spike off the edge there.
Yoshi just to punish.
Yeah, Jeff just making it back on the stage. Ooh.
Missing the setup.
Yep. Oh, and there it is. That's the first kill.
And Too Much Dog with a nice forward smash.
Yep. All right, Yoshi at 66%. Still got two lives. Ness only got one life here. Well, Jeff is keeping up. Doing his best. Ooh, and there's with the bat. All right. And there's a life off of Yoshi, so... Ness and Yoshi. Yep. Ness and Yoshi both got one life here. Ness got a little more damage on him, but Jeff totally has the potential to make that up. Just dodging that egg shot there. Oh, there's the spike. That was absolutely brutal. And Jeff is down, taken out in round one. Ross the boss. Too much dog. We'll move on to round two. Oh, wait. Sorry, there's another game.
There's way too much dog.
All right, that's game one. This will be game two of...
Bringing on some Donkey Kong.
Oh, my. Jeff taking out his Donkey Kong, which he has defeated me with in the past. So this is Jeff versus Russ, Mr. Two Stock versus Too Much a Dog, round two. And where are they going?
He's definitely want to go Battlefield here.
Oh, do you think they're going to go Battlefield?
That's Donkey Kong's best advantage here. I definitely think he's killed.
Yep, they're going Battlefield. Round two has been Battlefield every single time so far.
He's going to go with the Grape Soda Donkey Kong.
Grape Soda Donkey Kong. All right. Yeah, and even though Donkey Kong is not a terribly fast character, he's beaten me as Lucina, who is an incredibly fast character, but what do I know?
Well, Donkey Kong has some really good setups in this game. And
he absolutely does.
For a lot of games, he's not as slow as he typically
no.
is.
Although Donkey Kong is the worst ranked in some tiers, he's still doing his best to keep up with Yoshi here. LaRoss is just slightly ahead again.
Oh, he's about mid-tier in this game.
Is he?
Yeah, he's about mid-tier.
Okay. That's how I'm a lowest tier. And they're still neck and neck here. 80-90%. One big hit from either of these combatants will get a kill right about here. Jeff trying for those grabs. Oh, and there he gets one. That's just barely getting back. Oh. And dodging that smash there. Both combatants above 100%. Donkey Kong at 121. Oh!
And there we go.
Spikes Yoshi off the stage.
A little bit of confidence from Donkey Kong.
Yep. Alright, so Yoshi really just needs one more hit on Donkey Kong to make this very even game still. Oh! Oh, not quite. Still not a single hit on Yoshi, though.
That was a nice tech you did there.
That was. Alright. 175% on Donkey Kong. Ooh, still not falling off. Coming back with the helicopter. He's still not dead. Oh, still not dead. 199%. We're almost at 200%. Oh, 215%. And Yoshi finally rockets him off the stage. Yoshi at 53%. This is looking like a Jeff game. Oh, but if Ross can get that spike, which he is almost infamous for around here, this match will be over very quickly. Ooh.
Oh,
and there it is! And the spike. Again, brutal. Jeff doing very well. Oh, commendable. Ross takes round one, 2-0.
But no, it was a good match.
Absolutely a good match. Oh, that was enjoyable. All right.
So, next matchup.
All right, so.
We have Game & Watch Jr. and then Austin.
Oh, it's Game & Watch Jr.
Game & Watch Jr.
Game & Watch Jr. versus Austin?
Yeah.
All right, so I believe this other Austin we have here is a newcomer as well.
Yep, he is a newcomer. I haven't seen him here yet.
Game & Watch Jr. has been here a few times.
Also in high school.
Yep, I believe he brought Project M here. Alright.
We support the youth.
Absolutely. We ask this. This is. Don't do drugs, kids. Do Smash. Alright. So we have. Game & Watch Jr. staying true to his name. Speaking of Mr. Game & Watch, so we'll have Game & Watch versus Little Mac a game here. So. Little Mac, very heavy hitting character. Game & Watch, just kind of weird in general. But Game & Watch absolutely has some heavy hitting attacks if he wants to. Now Austin changing his name here. Sorry, we're not set up the names beforehand. We were doing some friendly matches with another TV on the other side. Still doing, looks like 8 player smash right now. Yes.
Where is Jibbles at?
It actually has
All right. Here we go. We have Collins. Little Mac is at a disadvantage due to the fact that there is a ledge. And you know, he may not be wrong. Because Little Mac not doing too well right now. This is a very small stage. Little Mac absolutely has potential to side B right off the side. Although, I don't think Game Watch is even going to let that happen. Little Mac...
Yeah.
Little Mac's already down with first kill. Yeah, Little Mac has absolutely no recovery, and that is his one flaw.
This is not the greatest stage for Little Mac.
No, it really isn't. Game Watch.
Figure out why they're playing. Oh.
Ooh. Little Mac with a second SD, and that's two down.
See, I don't know why they're playing Omega on that stage. That's a completely legal stage.
Yeah. No, absolutely. It's not a very big stage in the first place. So Game Watch Junior takes game one of this round. How will Austin respond? Will he change characters? Okay. The last match was not very long. Oh, he is changing characters. Who's he going to play? Currently having a debate over which color of Mr. Game & Watch is most like money. Then all right. So I believe it is Pikachu versus Cash Money Game & Watch on Final Destination. This is game two of I forgot the names of Game & Watch Junior versus Austin.
Pikachu really has an advantage here if he can play it right.
Yep. Oh.
Oh God, that's
Pikachu with the first SD. That is just tragic. Game & Watch teetering off the edge. It's an invitation. All right.
And there we go. We got
Game Watch SDing in turn.
We got the 1v1 with one life.
Yep. And it was a one life match here. 9% to 12%. Nope. Oh, Game Watch just wasting the 9. Game Watch still just a little bit ahead. Now Game Watch just a little bit behind. Pikachu pulling ahead. Pikachu, you not using a lot of thunder right now, gotta say. Because he absolutely could be using his side B dash attack on the stage, because it's a very flat stage. There's not a lot the Game Watch can go, but then...
Definitely needs to be using his neutral B a little bit more.
Yeah.
Definitely adds some setups.
Yep. Oh, there we go. Pikachu with the down B. Alright, so Game & Watch is getting pretty high percent here. Pikachu may actually take this, never mind. Game & Watch wins game two, and Game & Watch Jr. wins round one.
Alright, so next we have, here's Danny.
Oh, is this Dan?
Yup, and then Momo.
Oh, this is Dan versus Momo. This is going to be an interesting match. So, Dan...
Here goes Momo.
Momo,
he's got the glasses on. He's got the beats in.
Yep. Momo.
Oh yeah, the lower quality beats. And
so Momo is president of Smash Club, a renowned, really good Samus player, and he'll be playing Dan, who I believe just joined kind of at the beginning of this year, along with most everybody else that's here. But Dan is very good at Rosalina and Luma. One of the higher tier characters, so we'll see how this goes. We'll see who they actually pick, because Dan has also played a lot of Pikachu.
Now I know Momo's not picking Jigglypuff.
I've seen Momo play Jigglypuff before.
I've never seen
it. It was brutal. It was amazing. I watched him fight Jeff as Jigglypuff.
What? Oh, I didn't pick a winner.
Dan playing as Meta Knight. I don't know if I've seen Dan play as Meta Knight a lot.
A
Momo playing as Mewtwo. This is a matchup I haven't seen out of either of these fighters.
He's actually quite good with Meta Knight.
Going to do a Mega Orbital Gate Assault.
Alright. Momo's Mewtwo.
Yep.
The only Mewtwo player in existence, actually.
Yeah.
Okay, there's two Mewtwo players.
There are two Mewtwo players in existence. We are confirming this. If there are more Mewtwo players out there, and you would like to confirm your existence, please like, comment, and subscribe. All right, both fighters starting out pretty good. Mewtwo just a little bit ahead. Yeah, Mennonite doing a lot of his side B, which is clearly his best move. So, Momo's smashing quite a bit. Oh, Momo's... Mewtwo is fully charged. Oh, never mind. Wasted an aura ball there. That's alright.
Smash comes first. What are you doing?
I wish.
Mennonite pulls ahead just a little bit. Seems to adapt at least a little bit to Momo's attack patterns. Mewtwo is not a terribly quick character. He can be very heavy hitting if you play him right, but... Momo is, yeah, there's very short fuse on those aura balls. You don't have to charge them for very long. So Momo is making good use of those. Making good use of his up being his teleport.
Oh, and getting one of the nice forward smash.
There's his first kill.
You know he's heavy in the actual game of Pokemon, light as hell in Smash Bros. Makes no absolute sense.
That is true, but I suppose they need to do that for balance. Alright.
Quite powerful, though.
Oh, absolutely. Mennonite already getting a whole bunch of hits in on Mewtwo.
Nice combo.
Mennonite still sitting pretty comfortable at 70%. I don't think Mewtwo can kill him at 70. And Mewtwo himself is right back up to 60%.
Definitely in kill percentage.
You think so?
Yeah.
All right.
Mewtwo's very light.
We'll see if he has the potential to do it.
I think the only character who's actually lighter than Mewtwo in this game is Jigglypuff.
Oh, wow. Not even Kirby?
I think Kirby's actually a little bit heavier.
That's amazing.
It makes no sense. Sakurai needs to get on that instead of adding Cloud to games that you don't
Yes,
want.
Cloud has apparently just been announced, and I still personally am in complete disbelief because Cloud has been rumored to be in every Smash probably since Melee. But, ooh, Mewtwo with a very solid hit, and then like, getting that first kill. But Mewtwo's already at 8%.
Mewtwo's really going to have to avoid.
Yep.
Oh,
ooh, there it is. Mennonite with a second kill at 0%. So Dan takes first round. Been a lot of upsets here. People who I thought were going to win have not. So this is a very interesting tournament, at least for me.
Danny plays very consistently. He plays like every day.
Danny does play very, very consistently. He plays well consistently. Momo going as Luigi second round. Also not something I expected. I suppose he plays Samus more for large multiplayer matches.
An interesting fact about Danny is, even though it's called Omega Stages, he loves to call them horseshoes.
Yes, he says they're horseshoe stages.
It looks like a horseshoe.
It looks like a horseshoe, he says.
It looks like a horseshoe.
So we are doing Mennonite versus Luigi on Horseshoe Sky World. And we'll see how this one plays out. Mennonite taking the first round. Luigi and Mewtwo are very different characters, very different play styles. So we'll see... See how Momo does as Luigi. I haven't seen Momo play Luigi in quite a while.
Yeah, I don't really see him play Luigi too much.
No.
But he can definitely get the right setups. It is to Luigi's advantage.
Yep. And Luigi is actually a rather good character. Somewhat underrated, at least seen. Ooh, Mennonite just bringing the pain here. Again, that tornado attack, which is totally balanced.
This is not Brawl.
This is not Brawl. We like to confirm this is Smash 4, not Brawl. And Luigi getting at least a few hits in.
Ooh.
There we go. Good dodge. Ooh. Mistake may be fatal, and there it is. Mennonite with the first kill on Luigi. So Mennonite's only at 28%. This will be very, very hard for Momo to close the gap.
There's really a lot of hype between this match. I'm feeling like everyone's eyes are actually glued to this match, but
yeah.
There's actually two of our top players here over at Mass Smash.
Oh, absolutely. You always see Dan and Momo in the highest, in the last rounds of a tournament. Although, typically Momo is either in the finals or reigning supreme, just no matter what. But Dan is doing very, very well here. I haven't seen this matchup between Momo and Dan, although I've seen him fight many times before. And this seems to be working out quite a bit in Dan's favor, actually. Meta Knight 94%. Luigi can get this kill in if he wants to. But, ooh. Meta Knight getting a lot of good up B hits in. Meta Knight 100%, just barely dodging the smash. Meta Knight's 113%. Luigi just has to get one solid hit in.
He's definitely trying to go for the hype with those side Bs. I can tell him trying to gain some momentum back.
He is, but Meta Knight is very fast and has a lot of good dodges. If he up Bs, he can escape that. Ooh!
Sure you can.
There he goes. Luigi sure you can Meta Knight into non-existence. Getting the first kill on Luigi there. Meta Knight there, sorry. So, Meta Knight's still just a bit ahead, 62% to 64%, but this could be anyone's game at this point.
It's very close.
Luigi has been closing the gap, although Meta Knight's still bringing the pain. Personally, I want to see a round three. I want to see Momo play Samus, but we may or may not get that. Luigi at 89%, just barely avoiding the edge there. Ooh, Meta Knight with the teleport. Luigi at 106%. One more hit like that and he is out.
I'm actually going to step away for a quick second.
Alright. Meta Knight still getting some solid hits in. Meta Knight at 80%. Luigi still needs to get just a little bit more. Get that kill on Meta Knight. Ooh. Oh, there it is. Meta Knight has taken out Luigi. Dan wins round one. There it is. He didn't use Samus. People are upset about this. All right. So, since my co-commentator Nick is also in the tournament, he has stepped aside from what I believe. What is he in? All right. So I believe Nick is going off to prepare for his match right now. He was actually supposed to play earlier, but wanted to at least warm up. Before his bout, and he'll be fighting Jibbles, although I'm not sure if that match will be happening first, or, what? Okay. I'm not sure if that match will be happening first, or K-Side 12 versus Chance.
Are we doing Chance and K-Side?
Alright, we're doing Chance and K-Side 12. So, alright, Chance has been at Smash Club forever. Queso's been here the last couple of times. He's got one of them really cool limited edition 3DSs, you know the one. The gold one. Alright, I have a new commentator. This is Trevor. He's been at Mav Smash for basically forever, so introduce yourself.
Trevor, also known as Gara. I mostly joined in on this tournament. I'm not going to also tell who I use because it's more. So,
you'll see him later on. He's in the last round of round one. And looks like we're ready to start here. We have K-Sod as Sonic and Chance as Fabulous Falcon. So this is going to be a very interesting match. Both very very melee characters, but Sonic, as everyone on the internet knows, is incredibly fast. But Falcon is very powerful. You can get enough hits in on Falcon, you should be able to take this match.
It's going
to
be Sonic's home turf.
Although Sonic already bringing the pain. Captain Falcon up to 44%.
What's the Sonic's
tag? What?
K-Sad 12. Yeah. Sonic's, there's a clarification question about Sonic's actual screen name here. Although, honestly, anyone plays Sonic is an asshole, so it could be assumed. It doesn't really matter.
It's just one of those that...
Yep.
I've not seen, right now I've never seen K-Sad play, but I've seen Chance play a lot, and the fact that, he's back, I've never actually seen him down a kill.
I've seen Chance play Falcon quite a bit, and Chance is a very good Falcon.
I'm surprised he didn't choose Link. That's usually his main character.
That is true. But I've also seen K-Sad play before. I don't think I've ever seen him play as Sonic, but he's been in the last couple of tournaments, and I think he's done rather well. So we'll see how this matches up right here. They're pretty even still. Both dealing some heavy hits. Chance with a good shielding there.
What is that name?
What? Cum dump. That's just something he likes to do. We like to have fun here. We've had quite a few interesting names. I believe there was one particular instance when, because Dan especially likes to call Little Mac Little Sack. So there was one time where the entire nickname roster was filled up with things like Touch My Sack, Fabulous Sack, Tasty Sack, Big Sack. I don't remember what they all were, but
there's too many of them.
There were too many. Captain Falcon getting a lot of damage in on him here. Sonic still at 83%. If Captain Falcon can nail him with a Falcon Punch, he may just get the kill here. Because Sonic is not a terribly heavy character.
It's not a terribly heavy character, but hitting a Falcon Punch on a character this fast, you've got to really get
it. It's absolutely going to be a challenge, but it may be all he's got. And Sonic got the first kill there. Captain Falcon down. Already at 32%. Sonic's still getting hit, but he's still within KO range. Yeah. But Falcon just needs to get a good solid Falcon hit on him. No,
that's not a good thing. I mean, even just the elbow doesn't really need a Falcon punch.
Yeah.
He adjusts anything.
Nope. Sonic's up and over 100%. Just needs one good hit on him.
Smashable.
Yeah. Ooh, just barely missing with that side B. It has a shorter range than you think it does, always. Sonic's still nailing Captain Falcon.
Oh, this is the power of punch.
Ooh, and there it is.
There's the elbow.
Captain Falcon has fisted Sonic into oblivion. This is not a fan fiction I would like to read. So Sonic back at 0%. Captain Falcon still at 74, so if Sonic is still perfectly capable of dealing a lot of damage. Unless Captain Falcon can get a lot of good hits in, this is looking up to be K-Sad's game, at least for game one.
Miracles happen.
Miracles absolutely do happen. I ain't trying to jinx it. Fingers crossed. Chance is doing pretty well. You're getting his hits in Sonic where he can, although Sonic really is just too fast.
I mean, it's hard for a character that is meant to, you have to charge up.
Yeah. Oh, no, because Captain Falcon, his specialty is big, big hits. So if he's fighting against a heavy, slow character like King Dedede or Donkey Kong, then they're absolutely going to get destroyed. But against a light, fast character like Sonic, it's a much, much more difficult battle. Although he's still doing pretty well for himself. Captain Falcon at 90%, Sonic at 58%. I'd say this is still anyone's game at this point, although Sonic is looking very good still. Ooh. Captain Falcon over 100%. He's within KO range.
Oh.
And Chance S.D. is at the end.
Just completely missed the edge.
So K-Sad takes first game. We'll see how Chance will respond to this.
Because he does have the choice to choose a different character.
He absolutely may choose a different character. And honestly, I think he probably should, because just to... Oh, he does. Oh,
there it is.
Link. I've seen Chance play Link before. It isn't pretty. I mean that in a good way. See where they're going to go. Omega Luigi's Mansion. Very dark stage. Dark Link versus Dark Sonic on a dark stage.
A beautiful matchup.
Welcome to Emo Smash Club. I'm loving this, honestly. Not a hit has been dealt already.
The only thing I do not like is how... I'm just not a big fan of the soundtrack to this.
No, I've got the big headphones on. I can barely hear it all. It is very gloomy, though. So Link has actually been getting some good hits on Sonic, because Link, much faster character than Captain Falcon, I gotta say. Honestly, I hate fighting Link, because he's very well balanced. He can do long and short range, because he's got his bombs, he's got his arrows, he's got the grab. Oh, and his down A, of course. My absolute least favorite thing about Link and Toon Link.
No, Link just has a little bit more range, thus making it better than Toon Link. If only they were to make it, like,
like Toon Link would be faster or something, but it just isn't the case.
No, but Toon Link is shorter, I think. My girlfriend brought me some coffee, thanks.
Oh, you just had to say that, didn't you?
Absolutely.
Have to rub it in.
No regrets.
You don't have girlfriends here.
Don't worry about it, man. All right, Link trying to keep his distance. Link is ahead here. The Sonic doesn't have a lot of what I really call long-range moves. He does have those dashes. Ooh, Link just narrowly avoiding disaster there.
You're now starting to see why I do not like Link.
Yeah.
He just loves the spam.
Honestly, these are two characters I hate to play against. So really, I'm just enjoying the punishment on both sides. Oh, Link with a very solid backslash, taking the first kill off of Sonic. Link's still at 47%. This is looking very good for Chance. And he chose well doing Link Sonic.
It's just, if he wins, what's the reaction?
Yeah. That is going to be the question that we may or may not see answered here.
Oh,
but Sonic has to get a lot of hits in on Chance here if he wants to come back. Although, Link's still keeping it at a distance. Sonic with the grab. Ooh. Like almost off that edge there. What'd you say?
I thought he was going to do like a downbeat there. And I was gonna
Not quite. Ooh. That was very good. Link artfully dodging that Sonic dash attack. Sonic with the grab. Getting Link
up
there.
Keep going grabs here.
Yeah. No, grabs. You know, grabs might just be the way to go in this battle. Sonic can get a good dash and then a grab in. He may be able to do significant damage to Link. Ooh. Again, just narrowly grabbing the edge. Because that Link's up B does not get him a lot of height. Oh, Sonic there. The mega punch. Getting Link off the edge, but still not killing him. He is in KO range, so if Sonic can get another good hit in on him and, you know, not fall off the edge right here. Oh, and there it is. Chance takes game two without a kill on him at 116%. So we are at round three here, round three hype. And we'll see how Quezad responds to Link. Will he change characters?
You got a change of skin on the Link, though.
Of course.
Name change here.
Oh, Chance is changing his name. We'll see if he actually goes with Chance or what he's
going
to do.
Cream.
Because he is Cream Link, I guess. Quezad apparently staying as Sonic. Alright.
An interesting choice there.
Looks like they're still going Omega Stage. Oh, nope. They're going straight up Final Destination.
The little
Fox only.
Final Destination one. Yep.